Welcome back to the Blazer Puzzle. This is episode 69. I'm Carl Franklin from AppVNX, and that's my friend Jeff Fritz from Microsoft. Hey, Jeff, how you doing today?
How do, Carl? I learned an interesting fact over the weekend.
Oh?
It turns out if cars don't have oil in them, they're not going to work too good.
Dude, you're a grown man. You should know better than that.
It wasn't me. It was my daughter. Oh. But one of those things, as a parent, got to teach them. Got to teach them.
Yeah, it's a life lesson. Cars need oil.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, anyway, I hope everything's nice down there in Philadelphia. Up here in Connecticut, it's a balmy 54 degrees, I think, Fahrenheit.
Mid-50s so here.
Yeah, we'll take it. Even if the car doesn't run.
Doesn't run.
Let's jump into the puzzle, which is one of yours.
Oh, it's going to be a good one.
All right, play the music. All right, what do we got here?
All right, I'm a big fan of using the quick grid that ships with Blazor, right? Mm-hmm. You've got an interactive website. You want to just put together a little grid of information, stuff that's related. And I've got this data set that we've been using for a bunch of episodes. That's a list of episodes and episode numbers here.
Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to put it into a little quick grid and show some of the features of quick grid and dig into particularly sorting.
Okay.
So what's really cool about quick grid, let me show you the source code real quick for this grid. I can bind to an iQueryable list here, my list of episodes, and I just have them hard coded in memory.
Yeah,
but I can set up these property columns that bind directly to like the title, the episode number, and I can say sortable equals true here, and it'll start sorting and presenting that information. And I even have a property column for the published date, and I've got my two-string formatting on there and specifying that I want it short date formatted. And when I go back over to the browser, everything looks pretty good here. So I can click on the title and it sorts alphabetically ascending. Mm-hmm. And again, then it goes descending. So strings, no problem sorting. When I go in and do that with episode numbers, I mean, it's integers, right? So of course, digits, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, turn it the other way and it starts at 26 and counts down. I only have 26 episodes
loaded. Sounds good.
What happens when I work with dates?
Well, the first thing I guess you have to do is allow sorting.
Yeah, you're right. So I'm going to go turn on sortable on this so that we can start working with that. And that's, we saw it in the other two columns here. I'll just say sortable equals true.
Right.
Save that and hot reload kicks in. And now I'll click my publish date and that's not quite right.
So you're sorting by month, and then day, and then year.
Yeah.
And that doesn't really sort dates. To sort dates, you really want the first date to the last date in its entirety. You know, Jeff, I knew dates were not, we were not done with dates.
No.
Dates are the bane of my programming existence. I hate dates. I hate date only. I hate time span. All of that stuff really, really stinks.
So viewers out there, we need your help.
Yeah.
How do we solve this? We're going to take a few seconds here and pause. You can press pause on the player right there. So you can take a few minutes and try and figure this out, look it up, and we'll be back in a few to show you the answer.
Absolutely. All right, Jeff, what's the answer? How can we sort by the entire date? Not just by the month and then the day and then the year.
There's a couple different ways that you can do this, but the easiest way to do this is to take advantage of the format. So I kind of fooled ourselves here by putting the two string inside our property binding here. Get rid of that. And then you can add a format attribute here and specify, in our case, I want the short date format.
Yeah, what's interesting is it looks the same, right? Except that the property is establishing what the data is and, you know, coming in, and the format is how it's going to be presented going out.
Yep. There you go.
So that is a big, big difference. And in fact, when you do a two string, you're sorting by a string, aren't you?
Yep, exactly. And that's why we saw January next to October next to November.
Yeah.
Right. So if I go back over and we start sorting, now we get appropriately. Here's March 2024,
nice.
February 2024, then January, and then December before that. So,
wow, that's a subtle little thing.
Very subtle. Work. But it also gives us that freedom that I can jump back in here and change that format, of course, to uppercase D.
Sure.
And I immediately get the long date format.
Right. So this is all about the presentation right now.
You got it.
Yeah. You're not actually changing the date that you're bound to, the data that you're bound to.
Yep.
All right. I have another question for you since I'm
Fire
seeing
away.
This for the first time. Mm-hmm, you mm-hmm. have an image there.
I do. Yeah. Right. And it's good to have a thumbnail.
Yeah. I'm trying to imagine how you could sort by image and what that would look like.
You can sort by image.
How? I mean, how does it, you're not doing OCR or anything like that. How are you going to sort by image?
You know what? I think we should ask our viewers.
Okay. So another puzzle?
Another bonus puzzle.
A bonus puzzle.
Video.
Puzzle within a puzzle. All right. So if you think you know how to sort by image, just hold on a minute or come back and we'll be right back with the answer. Here we go again.
Here we go.
All right, I'm dying to know how you do this.
Here's the thing. When you have a template column like we have here for these images, we can add extra information to give it instructions about how to sort that. So take a look. Not only do we have the sortable Boolean column here, but I also have sort by, and we can pass in a function that will specify exactly how to sort this column. So let me define something that I'll call episode sort.
Okay.
And I'll just go down here inside the code block and I'll set up a property that is my grid sort called episode sort. So grid sort is a way for us to provide a little bit of a delegate, a pointer that says, hey, take this thing and sort initially, in this case, by descending on the title.
Well, wait a minute. If you have the sort by, do you need sortable equals true, or does that automatically set sortable to true?
It automatically comes along when you specify this little delegate that is going to provide the sorting mechanism for it.
Nice. Yeah.
So with those two updated, I'll go back over to the browser. Now I can click on the image.
Okay.
And it sorts. And you'll notice because I specified title that the title on the left is properly in alphabetical order.
Right. And more importantly, the title in the image lines up with the title on the left. It's the same thing.
Yep.
Because they come from the same record.
You got it.
Yeah. So tricky, tricky, tricky.
And hey, if you did want to do more complex investigation of that image to do further sorting, pre-calculate that and pass that extra column in somewhere and go and sort on that thing.
Right.
You can Whatever absolutely that might be. Do that.
Yeah. Yeah. Number of purple pixels, for example.
Brightness.
Yeah.
Right? Sort bright images to dark images.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Wow. That was short and sweet. And of course, you know, QuickGrid is good for, as Jeff said, quick and dirty things. But most people, if they're doing real, you know, data grids and things, will use a more robust third party tool. But that's not what this is for. This isn't to take the place of those things.
Yeah. This is those more sophisticated grids out there do all kinds of great things, including exporting to Excel. Really, really neat stuff.
Yeah. I would use this where I would have a table you know, for example, with sorting
totally.
And searching and stuff. All right. Thank you, Jeff. Thanks, everybody. And of course, if you have any questions or comments for us or some suggestions, you can send them to blazerpuzzle@appvnext.com. And who knows, we might send you a mug if you send us a problem and a solution. Okay? See ya.
Alrighty. Take care, friends.
Bye. Thanks for watching. Make sure to check out blazertrain.com and the .NET show.com for more great content.